So India is where we started experimenting with this water credit or working with financial institutions. Initially, it was very hard. It was hard to convince a financial institution that somebody would borrow for building a toilet or for getting a water connection. And it was even harder to convince them that people would repay. They thought, this loan is not for income generation, so how will they repay? It was hard to convince the borrowers too, because the person in need, if she was convinced that she needed to build a toilet, she said, why should I take a loan for this? And that's how we started more than 10 years ago. And initially the graph was very flat, but over the last few years, we've seen the demand and the numbers really exponentially increase. So what are the numbers? In India, our partners have made 1.7 million odd loans, accumulating about $400 million, reaching about 8 million people, again, enabling access to water and or sanitation. Remember, it's a financially viable business for our partners. It's a commercial business. That's the only way it stays sustainable. But on day one, it's not a financially viable business, or it might not be a financially viable business, which is why we give grants for a limited period of time. So again, in India, to enable the $400 million of capital which our partners have deployed, our cumulative grants have been about $12 million. So that's the leverage through our work with our financial partners we've been able to achieve. It's a combination of institutions. It could be microfinance entities, which is where we started, and microfinance entities continue to be a large part of our partner base. It could be self-help group organizations. These are organizations which directly borrow from banks. It could be banks directly, or it could be government-owned livelihood missions. Think of any channel which has the last mile reach. And our role as catalyzing and enabling these channels to reach the last mile, to reach the BOP with small loans. The average loan size in India has been a little over $200. And this is important, the loans have been repaid at 99%. And I think this breaks a big myth that poor do not pay back or poor are not credit worthy. So this is good. We've reached 8 million people in India. We have visions of reaching many more. But again, if you go back to the numbers I talked about right at the beginning, the number of people in need is much, much more. So in summary, poor are not a problem to be solved. They have their own solutions, and what they often lack is the upfront capital to make these solutions work. And that's what Water.org is trying to prove at scale, that lending to the BOP for meeting their water and sanitation needs is a commercially viable and sustainable business proposition for the lenders.